If you're trying to conceive, if you're struggling with infertility, miscarriage, male factor, and you're looking for ways to improve your chances, you have probably come across some information about CoQ10. Today, I'm going to separate fact from fiction when it comes to coenzyme Q10 and your fertility. I'm Dr. Laura Shaheen. I'm a double board certified OBGYN and reproductive endocrinologist helping people build families for almost 20 years. And in my 20 years, I've absolutely seen fertility fads come and go. Supplements are hot and then they're not. But coenzyme Q10 has definitely kept my interest. And it's something that I talk to my patients about every day. And I'm happy to share with you more information today. I love educating, and I'm so glad that you found this channel. If you have more questions about other supplements and prenatal vitamins and how to find safe supplements, I have a whole playlist here called Lifestyle Optimization for Your Fertility. Be sure and subscribe to this channel so you get my weekly videos all about reproductive health, another great way to stay connected and to learn more. All About Reproductive Health is my podcast, Baby Your Best Fertility Podcast. You can listen to it anywhere you listen to your podcast. It's got great interviews and content all about reproductive health. But today we are going to talk all about coenzyme Q10. We're going to go over five main topics. Number one, we're going to learn what CoQ10 is. I'm going to help you understand what this magic supplement is. Number two, we're going to go over exactly how coenzyme Q10 works. Number three, we're going to go over some important side effects. Too much is not always a good thing. Topic number four, we're going to go over the evidence around coenzyme Q10 impacting female fertility. And topic number five, we're going to go over coenzyme Q10 and its impact on male factor fertility. Now stick around to the end of the video where I'll share with you what I tell my own patients. Topic number one, what is CoQ10? CoQ10 or coenzyme Q10 is an antioxidant. It's found in many cells in our body, and it's in high concentration in our heart and our skeletal muscle and our liver and kidneys. And we do find it in our reproductive organs and eggs and sperm. CoQ10 is a huge part of energy processes within the cell. It's a part of the inner mitochondrial membrane, which is the powerhouse of each cell, and it helps DNA and your cells function the way they're supposed to. It helps with a process called oxidative phosphorylation, which results in the production of ATP, or adenosine triphosphate, which is the absolute energy power of the cell. Basically, it helps your cells function and do what they need to do. And there are two specific cells in the body that we really care about. If we care about fertility, that is the egg cell and the sperm cell. We know that levels of coenzyme Q10 decrease with age, just like our fertility and our reproductive health decreases with age. And it's been theorized that if we could add CoQ10 to our diet or as a supplement, it might improve our overall reproductive health. Now, you can find CoQ10 in some foods, specifically meat, fish, and nuts. But a lot of times people will take it as a supplement. And that's what we're really talking about today. Is CoQ10 worth taking? And if you do take it as a supplement, how much should you take? And what is it really doing in your body? Topic number two. So how does coenzyme Q10 or CoQ10 work? We talked a little bit about how it works within the cell as a part of energy processes and so many cellular functions, especially when you're reading DNA. In our cells, there's a delicate balance between oxidative stress and a buildup of free radicals as our cells are doing all of this use of energy and functions that they need to. Antioxidants like coenzyme Q10, others that you've probably heard of, vitamin C, vitamin E, zinc, selenium, antioxidants help decrease free radicals. That decreases the oxidative stress in your cells and helps your cells work better. So antioxidants like CoQ10 have really special roles within our cells. Number one, they play a central role in creating ATP or the energy for our cells. Number two, they neutralize free radicals to decrease oxidative stress to allow our cells to work better. And number three, they really limit cellular damage within the cells so our cells can work better, especially those eggs and sperm. Topic number three, side effects. Too much is not necessarily a good thing. So some side effects with taking CoQ10 include some headaches, GI upset like upper abdominal pain, nausea, diarrhea, irritability, insomnia, some itchiness and skin irritation, and even fatigue. I have to remind you that supplements are not regulated by the FDA in the United States. And so they are not spot checked. They are not always exactly what they say they are on the label. So you have to be very careful when you're buying supplements. You want to find things that are third party tested and just be very careful about your sourcing because supplements are not well regulated in the United States. So be very careful. And also when you take supplements, be sure and tell your doctor exactly what you're taking, all prescription medications and all supplements, because things can interact. And it's just so important for your doctor, for us to know exactly what you're taking so we can help you best. Topic number four, what does the evidence show about coenzyme Q10 and female fertility? So you might have heard about CoQ10 if you're looking for questions and doing searches on how do I improve my egg quality? How do I improve my chances of success with IVF, decrease miscarriage? You're often going to come up with a lot of recommendations and CoQ10 often comes up. And so where does this come from? And what does the evidence show? Well, we know that eggs inside our ovaries, inside our bodies, are using a ton of energy in order to read DNA. When we ovulate, we have to get rid of half of our copies of chromosomes. This is the chromosomes carry all the genetic mapping and blueprint for everything that's going on in our body and the development of the embryo. And when we ovulate, our eggs have to get rid of half of their copies of the chromosomes in order to fertilize with sperm. And this process then results in an embryo that is cells are dividing, DNA is duplicating and splitting apart. And there's so much energy that goes on with this whole process. We know that fertility declines with age. We know that there are more chromosome errors that happen when eggs ovulate. When they're older, we know there's a higher chance of chromosome abnormality that leads to a higher risk of miscarriage. So much changes with age that it is a theory and it is reasonable to kind of put together the thought that if you could help with that energy process and decrease the free radicals within cells that are doing all of that DNA replication, that you might be able to improve fertility. So people have looked at this in a lot of different ways, you know, animal models, testing CoQ10 levels and follicular fluid. And it's pretty interesting what some of the studies have shown. And I'm really excited to share it with you now. A simple study has shown that coenzyme Q10 levels decrease with age, specifically within the follicular fluid. So a really interesting study just looked at coenzyme Q10 levels within follicular fluid from women that were older compared to follicular fluid from women that were younger. And the women who were older had lower levels of coenzyme Q10 within their follicular fluid. Such a simple study and such an interesting way to show something different with age. Animal studies using coenzyme Q10 supplements to rats have shown higher number of eggs retrieved with ovarian stimulation, higher number of embryos created when the rats were given coenzyme Q10. Another animal study is looking at bovine cells and embryos and showing those with higher levels of coenzyme Q10 actually had lower fragmentation of the blastocyst, better blastocyst formation, and really in vivo, you know, in the lab, looking at the blastocysts develop when there was higher levels of CoQ10, those embryos did better. But what's happening in human studies? Interesting study. It's small, but it did look at humans that were going through IVF, 39 total. Half of the women were given coenzyme Q10, 600 milligrams daily, and the other half were given placebo pills. So they were taking pills, but there was no CoQ10 in them. It was just a sugar pill. And comparing the women that got the coenzyme Q10 actually had more eggs, more blastocysts, and when they did chromosomal screening or PGT-A, those women had a lower percentage of aneuploidy or imbalanced chromosomes within their embryos. The rate of aneuploidy was 46.5% in the women that got coenzyme Q10 compared to 62.8% in the women that did not get coenzyme Q10. That's interesting. It's a small study. I will point out that when they did an embryo transfer, there was not a significant difference in pregnancy rates. So this is a small study. It's interesting. It is randomized and it is controlled. And some people got CoQ10 and some people didn't. The people that got CoQ10 seemed to have better IVF outcomes and lower aneuploidy rates. But there was not a difference in success of the overall IVF cycle. And again, this is a small study. It's interesting, but I wouldn't use the study to say like absolutely coenzyme Q10 is an amazing treatment, but it is very, very interesting and it's something to pay attention to. So these are interesting findings. There are a lot of studies out there and I will make sure and give you the references. But in general, we know that CoQ10 levels decrease with age, specifically within follicular fluid of older women compared to younger women. We saw in animal studies that giving animals coenzyme Q10 saw better blastocyst formation rate, lower fragmentation, and better outcomes in the lab. And in one study looking at a very few small numbers of humans going through IVF, we did see some improved outcomes with IVF, but not a significant difference in pregnancy rates, which is the ultimate goal of an IVF cycle. So very interesting. There's definitely rationale and plausibility for giving coenzyme Q10, but I wouldn't say that the evidence is out there to prove that it will improve pregnancy outcomes or IVF outcomes. Topic number 5, what about coenzyme Q10 and male fertility or sperm parameters? So it's a really interesting topic. It's easier to study sperm, honestly, because it's outside of the body and you can look at it easily under the microscope. And sperm are such energy powerhouses. They use up so much ATP. They're constantly reading DNA that it's a really interesting model to study how antioxidants could help sperm parameters and sperm function. And it's pretty easy to show that sperm need antioxidants in order to decrease those free radicals, use that energy within their cells in order to do what they need to do. And so CoQ10 is really interesting to study with sperm parameters. There are so many studies looking at CoQ10 and male parameters. There's an excellent review article that I will link here that really goes through exactly what CoQ10 is and how sperm can use antioxidants and what sperm are doing and the theories behind giving supplementation. There are studies that definitely show that CoQ10 levels are lower in men as they age. There are other studies showing that men with poor sperm parameters and male factor fertility have, in general, lower coenzyme Q levels compared to men with normal sperm parameters. And study after study has shown that coenzyme Q10 can improve sperm parameters in the men that have been studied and shown. Now, not every study shows it, but you can just find it pretty easily looking at giving coenzyme Q10, improving the sperm count, the sperm motility, the sperm morphology, and the overall parameters of the semen analysis. One specific fun study to show that was published in Fertility and Sterility looked at 60 infertile men. Half were given coenzyme Q10 200 milligrams daily for 6 months compared to the other half of men that were given a placebo pill. So no CoQ10, just a sugar pill. The men who received the coenzyme Q10 supplement had a higher level of CoQ10 levels within their semen. So you can study that level within the ejaculate. And so what they were ingesting was actually getting into the seminal fluid. And they were able to show that over that 6 month period, motility specifically improved for the men that were taking coenzyme Q10. They were not designed and they weren't powered, meaning they didn't have enough people that they were studying in order to really look for improved pregnancy rates. But 6 of the men who were taking CoQ10 in that 6 month period conceived spontaneously. That does not prove that it improves fertility or function of the sperm, but just a very interesting study. And I encourage you to look at it. So you stuck around to the end. Now you get to hear what I tell my own patients. I review optimizing overall health and well-being with all of my patients. I think it's really important to think about nutrition, sleep, exercise, stress management. I think that supplements can't substitute for healthy living, but they can be used within reason to just optimize. And especially antioxidants, I think, can really be helpful. You can find antioxidants in some foods, you know, like blueberries and other fruits and vegetables. But taking a supplement, I think, could be a good idea for a lot of my patients. I talk to my patients about prenatal vitamin, vitamin D, because we live in the Pacific Northwest. I practice in Seattle, and I think it's 85% of people in the state of Washington are vitamin D deficient. So I always recommend a little bit of extra vitamin D. And then I do talk to most of my patients about coenzyme Q10. I talk to my patients about finding supplements are third-party tested and not falling for the marketing gimmick of super expensive fertility supplements. Some of them are good, but some of them, they're really spending more money on marketing rather than actually high quality ingredients. So making sure that the supplement is third-party tested and really thinking about kind of what you need. Patients often ask me like, oh, there's two different types of coenzyme Q10. There's ubiquinol and ubiquinone. Which one should I take? And actually, early studies looking at older patients with limited kidney and liver function were concerned that maybe one form would be more easily digestible and usable. But actually, these days, we've really learned that the body can convert ubiquinol to ubiquinone. And so really, you can take actually either one. Your body will use either one quite well. So if you ingest ubiquinol or ubiquinone, your body is going to convert it to the active form, which is ubiquinol. I talk to most of my patients about taking 200 milligrams of CoQ10, either formulation, a day. I don't always recommend a high level. Sometimes people will be recommended to take 600 milligrams if they have significant male factor or significant diminished ovarian reserve. But I do warn about the side effects. And so if someone is feeling those side effects that we listed earlier, I say, okay, let's back it down. And I think about most people really don't need more than 200 milligrams a day. Now, that is my personal thought, what I share with a lot of my patients, but I really do individualize for each patient's particular situation, and you should talk to your doctor about your situation. Make sure, again, that you are going over all of your prescription medication and all of your supplements with your doctor, because some things can interact and some things can be counterproductive, and you really want to be thoughtful about where you are sourcing your supplements. Look for supplements that are third-party tested, and remember, more is not necessarily better. I hope you learned something today. Like this video if you learned something. Comment with questions or topics you'd like to see me cover. Be sure and subscribe to this channel so you get my weekly video all about reproductive health. Stay in touch. There's a link to my newsletter below. Listen to the Baby Robust Fertility podcast. And until next week, I'm wishing you love, luck, and pineapples.